If you like American history, please subscribe to our channel and ring that bell so you can be notified when we put up a new video. On a barrier island off the coast of North Carolina stands this concrete structure. Many think this was an observation tower, built to sight German submarines lurking off the coast during World War II. The truth is much more remarkable. After the war, a top-secret Navy project used these observation towers while testing a new type of propulsion that revolutionized how we protected our Navy ships and eventually how our jets could fly into the supersonic reaches of outer space. This is the incredible story of Operation Bumblebee, next on Mark in History. This is the historical marker for missile test conducted in secret by the U.S. Navy between 1946 and 1948 on Topsail Island off the coast of North Carolina. The Navy built 8 concrete observation towers and an assembly building to fabricate, launch, and view as many as 200 experimental rockets as these scientists perfected the Ramjet missile. As a result of these secret tests, the foundation of modern rocketry and jet propulsion was laid out here on Topsail Island. Now, let's learn more about the story behind the marker. During World War II, the U.S. Navy experienced 2 devastating enemy tactics, which threatened the survival of our sailors and ships. Both involved enemy aircraft. It was September 11, 1943, and the USS Savannah was supporting the Allied landing at Salerno, Italy, in Operation Avalanche. During an air raid, a high-flying German bomber launched a new type of weapon towards the Allied cruiser, while outside the range of shipboard artillery. The German bomb penetrated the armored top of USS Savannah's number 3 turret and plunged through 3 decks to the lower handling room where it exploded. The blast blew a hole in the ship's hull and killed 197 men, including everyone in the turret and handling room. It nearly sank the entire ship. In October 1944, on the other side of the world, Japanese kamikaze bombers resorted to crash-dive attacks on our battleships and carriers. Our naval ships did not have the high-speed, long-range rockets necessary to stop the threats. Obviously, these new enemy tactics were a serious threat to U.S. Navy and maritime shipping. The Navy needed to intercept and destroy these bomb-carrying aircraft before they came close enough to launch their weapons. What they really needed was a supersonic surface-to-air missile. Thus was born the Navy's next top-secret project, Operation Bumblebee. In 1941, researchers at the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics used a high-speed wind tunnel to demonstrate the basic principles of operation of the ramjet engine. Most people in the aviation industry believed that jet engines could never produce as much thrust as a propeller. So this work was ignored until 1943, when U.S. Navy researchers were looking for ways to power their missiles. On December 1, 1944, John Hopkins University Applied Physics Laboratory, or APL, began a new research contract with the Navy to proceed with the development of guided jet-propelled missiles. The goal was to produce a prototype interceptor missile or prove that it couldn't be done. The answer was yes, it could be done, but it called for a vehicle that did not yet exist, a supersonic jet-powered guided missile. Enter Dr. Merle Tuve, founding director of the Applied Physics Laboratory and lead scientist on this new top-secret program. In early 1945, Dr. Tuve assigned the code word Bumblebee to this top-secret Navy project. He was inspired by this quotation on an office wall. "The Bumblebee cannot fly. According to recognized aerotechnical tests, The Bumblebee cannot fly because of the shape and weight of his body in relation to the total wing area. But the Bumblebee doesn't know this, so he goes ahead and flies anyway. The project name Operation Bumblebee seemed appropriate because Dr. Toof understood that the new missile program faced similar long odds for success. After the war ended in 1945, the Navy decided to continue the secret project. After several successes at Island Beach, New Jersey, and Delaware Beach, APL and Dr. Toove's team settled into a permanent secret facility on a barrier island off the coast of North Carolina in 1946. Today, it's called Topsail Island, but back then, it was simply called the Sand Spit. The location was perfect because of its isolation, accessed only by boat, and its close proximity to Camp Davis for housing the 250 team members and their families. Within months, the Navy had constructed roads, an assembly building, control tower, 8 observation towers, pontoon bridge, launching platform, and bomb-proof shelter. Their mission was to develop a jet-powered missile that could destroy an air target up to 20 miles away. 8 observation towers were built, each one housing a radar system, telemetry instruments, and cameras to record performance data along the 26-mile sandy coast. Towers were precisely located with distances scientifically derived from 0 up to 16 miles away. Triangulation of photo equipment from the towers recorded the flights over 10 to 20 miles at speeds of up to 1,500 miles per hour. So accuracy of the Ramjet data was vital. Basically, the Ramjet is an air-breathing jet engine that operates with no moving parts. It relies on the missile's forward motion to draw in air and compress it for combustion. Fuel, usually kerosene, is added and injected into the combustion chamber to be burned with the help of a flame igniter. The high pressure and high temperature gases are passed through the nozzle, converting pressure energy into kinetic energy and supersonic flight. In order to accelerate to operational Ramjet speed, a solid rocket booster is needed. Initially, Operation Bumblebee used high-velocity anti-aircraft rockets strapped to the end of the Ramjet to give it a kickstart. And because the transistor had not been invented yet, sturdy vacuum tubes were utilized for the Ramjet guidance systems. An estimated 200 rockets were launched over the course of 18 months off the North Carolina coast. These tests provided a blueprint to the development of jet aircraft engine technology and insights into rocketry incorporated later in NASA's space program. 3 missile types were developed over those years of testing on Topsail Island: the Terrier, the Talos, and the Tartar. Each had different applications for the Navy. The Talos, a long-range anti-aircraft missile, was created as the big gun of the Navy. The first working prototype Ramjet missile was flown in 1952, and the first tactical Talos missile was introduced into the Naval fleet in the spring of 1958. This surface-to-air missile extended the Navy ship self-defense from a few miles to over the horizon and the edges of space. In 1948, the Navy decided to close up shop at Topsail Island, North Carolina, and shift operations to White Sands, New Mexico, and Cape Canaveral, Florida. They moved the secret guided missile program to take advantage of better weather conditions, less sea traffic, and more range over the ocean.
2, 1, 0, and lift off.
Years later, the booster rockets developed in Operation Bumblebee paved the way to creating the solid rocket boosters on the space shuttle. These rocket boosters were essential to space shuttle launches. Today, you can still see the remnants of Operation Bumblebee. 7 of the 8 towers remain. A few remain undisturbed, guarding the North Carolina coastline. Some are used as private homes, and one was part of a fishing pier, which was lost in a hurricane. And then there is the assembly building. It's appropriate that this building has been listed in the National Register of Historic Places because of all the technology it has developed in aviation and rocketry. And if you want to learn more about Operation Bumblebee, go no further than next door to the Missiles and More Museum. You can't miss the Talos missile outside the entrance. Inside, you will see missiles hanging from the ceiling, historic photos hanging on display, and awesome t-shirts hanging by the entrance. The government had originally created Operation Bumblebee as a way to test the possibilities of guided missiles. In the end, Operation Bumblebee produced the first tactical supersonic missiles, which helped launch the U.S. into the 21st century. The success of the Bumblebee program at Topsail Island, North Carolina, can be plainly stated. Topsail Island is to jet flight development what Kitty Hawk is to propeller flight. If history can be taught with stories, it can never be forgotten. Please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell to stay informed on the latest videos. And don't forget to leave your comments and suggestions below for what markers you want to see next.